The topic I'm going to talk to you is called Dark Manipulation and Controlling Spirit. Dark Manipulation, Controlling Spirit, that the spirit that control people. They control you until you cannot, you are no, you are nothing. They are themselves. They want to do everything. They want you to do like they, like what they want. They want you to do like the way they want you to do. You can't tell them anything. You cannot say anything. They want to control you, everything. They want to rule you. They want to rule you. They are ruling you until you have nothing. They can rule you even into your bedroom, even to your house. They are manipulating, dark manipulating and controlling. They are very dangerous spirit that is controlling. Where the husband or a wife is manipulating, controlling, that marriage will never stand. Anywhere, even the church, that is witchcraft. It is witchcraft spirit. Dark manipulation and controlling is witchcraft spirit. People, they think that this is not a witchcraft. That is witchcraft. If your pastor is manipulating and controlling you, that is using spirit of witchcraft. Therefore, I'm going to talk to you, and you know you cannot be controlled. And we are going to pray the prayer that will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. You need deliverance of dark manipulation and controlling spirit. This is what is making people, they get confused, they lose their direction because of these wicked dark powers of manipulation controlling. And witchcraft manipulation controlling, this the witchcraft, they make you to do mistakes by yourself. They speak and they chant against you and make you to enter into mistakes. And here is also the pastor, a prophet, or whatever, a leader of the church. His power is controlling, and they want to know everything. They investigate you, everything they want to know. Or they want to know everything you have. They want everything to know. They are unfriendly friends. That they will come in as a friend, but they are enemies. They are at night, they are enemies. They are investigating you. They check everything you have. Everything you have, they check. And they even, the big churches, they have some people they send and bring to them the information. And when they get this information, they started manipulating you using the information they got. Therefore, I pray that anybody that is going through this dark manipulation and spirit of controlling, let them be scattered. Let them be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Even the leader, we call them dictators. You see, where the leader, in the Bible, we call them manipulator and controlling. In another, in the world, the other language, they call it dictators. Dictators are everywhere. They want to dictate you. They don't know democracy. You say there's democracy, but there's nothing like democracy. You see there's freedom, but there's nothing like freedom. You find a church being manipulating people, controlling people, until the people, they can't even pray. And you say there's freedom. There's no freedom. That is a lie, because they are lying and they are controlling. They are controlling you. But today, we will refuse to be controlled by this dark manipulation in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you, Father. I want to thank you for this great revelation in the mighty name of Jesus. We are going to look from the book of Matthew, Matthew 24, verse 4. Matthew 24, verse 4. Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, he is the one who is talking. He said, the Bible says, and Jesus answered them, see that no one leads you astray. See no one leads you astray. See no one control you. See no one deceive you. See no one control you. Refuse in the name of Jesus. Jesus himself has said, this is a dark manipulation. See nobody manipulating you. It is very dangerous. You have been manipulated by the power and the blood of Jesus. I cast out anybody that is manipulating you. Any manipulation, dark manipulation power, I destroy you in the name of Jesus. Jesus himself has said, and see, and Jesus said and answered them, see that no one leads you astray. Let me see. This is let me see what King James says. This is what you call it. English standard. Let me see what does the King James says in the book of Matthew 24 verse 4. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We are going to pray fire prayer today. You will never be deceived again. Anybody, wherever it is, who is this, you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. In the name of Jesus. That's why this prayer is very important for you. Thank you. Say thank yourself to come for these prayers. This is verse 4. The Bible says, Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you. Here King James said, let no man deceive you. This is manipulation. This is controlling. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Jesus has said, don't let anybody to deceive you, to manipulate you, to control you. Don't let them to control you. You have to stand and say no. Let your no be no and let your yes to yes. It's not going to kill you. Even if it's that judge, let him have his own charge. Don't let anybody deceive you either. Don't let anybody to control you. Let's look at another scripture. Matthew 23, verse 1 to 5. Verse 1 to 4. Yes, verse 1 to 4. Matthew 23. This is Jesus again. Then Jesus spoke to the crowds and to his disciples, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees have seated themselves in the chair of Moses. Therefore, all that they tell you, do not observe, but they do not do according to their deeds. For they say things and do not do them. They tie up heavy burdens and lay them on men's shoulders, but themselves are unwilling to move them with so much as a finger. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. God, I thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, Father, thank you, Jesus. Yes, you see what the Bible is saying. I thought somebody had a problem with the prayer conference. That's why I was looking at the phone. Yes, I pray that anybody that is deceiving you, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Look at this. Then Jesus spoke to the crowds and to his disciples, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees have seated themselves in the chair of Moses. Therefore, all that they tell you, do and observe, but do not do according to their deeds. For they say things and do not do them. They tie up heavy burdens and lay them on men's shoulders, but they themselves are unwilling to move them with so much as a finger. These are the people which tells you that do things, but themselves you can't do to them to what they are doing to you. Themselves you can't do what they are doing to you. Themselves nobody could do to what they are doing to you. They are manipulating you and controlling you, but themselves nobody will control them and manipulate them. They put a burden on your shoulder, but themselves they can't. Such a people you can't. If you try, you die. They will kill you. And you, they want you to control you and manipulate you. That is witchcraft. You will see, the Bible is declaring them, it's saying cast them. That is what the Bible says. They should be cast. You have to. You don't have to sit in the church where the pastor is controlling you, manipulating you, and you are a child of God. The Bible said they should be cast out and let them leave that church and another one to take over. You don't have to sit down and what been controlling. You are depressed. You are sick. a lady was calling in from a church that she has been controlled. She's a choir member, and the choir leader controlled them. Nobody's saying even a word. That what she said, that's what everybody's doing. Nobody, she doesn't give anybody a chance to talk. She's only one to talk, and that is her decision. I was reading some scriptures. They say more counselors. You need more counselors. When they are more counseling, then things will move properly. These dictators, manipulators, controlling, they are the only one who talks. Nobody can talk to them. Nobody will tell them. They control you, but them, no one will control them. No one will talk to them. They have rules, and they manipulate people, and they buy people using money to get favor from people. This manipulation, today, it is going to be an end. Anybody who is controlling you, manipulating you, today is an end. Even you can have your own children. They will control you, manipulate you, and then you say, what is this? Yeah? And they can even threaten you. That manipulation and controlling spirit, they are always threatening you. They are threatening you. They put you in a threatening. Always they scare you. If it is a husband, I'm going to leave you. If it is a woman, if it is a wife, I'm going to leave you. I'm going to divorce you. I'm going to... Every day they confess that. I know I was in St. Catherine, and this man was crying tears because of the woman was controlling and manipulating. And this woman, she was telling the man that she wanted to divorce. The man divorced a woman from 4 years ago. Now they have a baby. Now this man, he feared. He said, I don't want this thing to happen again. He was crying and telling me to help him. Yeah? The woman was so wicked and evil. And when I look at the woman, when I was talking with the woman was disrespecting me. She didn't kind me. She was condemning the husband, cursing the husband, saying bad stuff to the husband. Then I told the husband, open your eyes. No matter this is you can't live such a life like this. You have to decide what to do. Don't fear that she's going to divorce you, so you fear because the other marriage I didn't work. Because you didn't seek God. You rushed to marriage. Your marriage is not registered in heaven. That's the punishment you are getting me. Why did you rush to marry very quickly if you divorced the first one? So this manipulation is there. And it makes people to seek and going to hospital because of the depressed. They can threaten you and threaten you even at work. They can threaten you. You have no peace. So today we are going to stop them in the mighty name of Jesus. It is a sickness. It's not nice. It's witchcraft. The Bible says in the book of Galatians 1 verse 8. This is the book that Paul saying, but even if we or an angel from heaven should preach to you a gospel contrary to what we have preached to you, he is to be cursed. He is to be cursed. This manipulation, they are preaching different gospel. Paul is saying, even if it is the angel from heaven that is preaching the gospel contrary to what they preached, let that person be condemned. Let them be cursed. You say, the Bible is very clear here. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you so much because of your word. The Bible says, but through we or an angel from heaven preach an other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you. Let him be cursed. That's why we are going to cast those spirits. Because they are preaching the different gospel. They are not preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ also said, do not let anybody to deceive you. Now, these dictators, these manipulators, these controlling, they are deceiving you. Using the word of God and deceive you, put you astray, put you in the problem. Let these people be condemned, be cursed. That's what the Bible says. I did not wrote this. Look at that scripture. Why is the Bible say, Paul says, let them be cast. And Jesus also said, don't let them. Don't allow them. Don't allow them to come manipulate you. Because themselves, you cannot manipulate. They can't control you. They want to control you anytime they want, and they want you to submit, but themselves, they can't. Try to talk to them. You will see. That is witchcraft. But if you refuse in a spiritual way, they cannot penetrate. They can't. We have to go with prayers and refuse it. Do not fight with flesh and blood. If you fight with flesh and blood, they will defeat you. But when you go in the spiritual world, you will bring them down. You will scatter their position. You will remove them in the spiritual world. Like what we are going to pray now, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We pray that God forgive us and Lord help us in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm going to pray for you. All evil arrows from demonic agents fashioned against you, I command them to receive fire of God and melt to ashes in Jesus' name. I pray that every arrows, every manipulation that has been every power that has been manipulating you, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. I thank you, Father. Jesus, you are a great God. I pray all evil arrows from demonic agents fashioned against you, I command them to receive the fire of God and melt to ashes in Jesus' name. Every power from the kingdom of darkness manipulating you, controlling you, let this power be melt to ashes in Jesus' name. Let this power be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any personality, who is manipulating you, controlling you, let them be scattered in Jesus' name. Let them be scattered. Let their ways be scattered in the name of Jesus. Let those words not be manifested in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. God, I want to thank you, Father. Any authority, any leader that is controlling you is an ungodly way. That's witchcraft. Bible said no. You cannot control people like that. You are called to read people and pray for them and love them. You cannot treat people like dogs, like animals. God has called you to love people and help them. The church, when some people, they go to church, when they come from that church sick, because the pastors has tormented them so much. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the powers and the anointing of God that break evil yokes fall upon you now and break every evil chains, every feathers, every evil fetters, every evil bands off from your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that the power and the anointing of God that breaks the yoke, that break evil yoke, the anointing of Jesus Christ, the anointing that break the yoke, let it fall upon you and break every evil chains and break every evil feathers and break every evil bands and break every evil manipulation and break every evil controlling in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I pray that God, every door of evil that has touched your life for evil, receive the tormentment of the Holy Spirit and be confounded and confused in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray every evil doors of evil, every evil doors, every evil that has been done to you, every evil that has been done to you, let the power of God, let the Holy Spirit fight them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every evil doors of evil that has touched your life for evil, that has touched your life for evil, receive the tormentment of the Holy Spirit and be confounded and confused in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. I declare that every pronouncement from demonic agents against you shall not stand, neither shall they come to pass in the name of Jesus. I pray that every, I declare, I decree and declare by the power that created the heaven and the earth, every pronouncement from demonic agents against you shall not stand, neither shall they come to pass in the name of Jesus. That those manipulation will not stand. They will not stand. I am declaring them in the mighty name of Jesus. People who are suffering in this, in the hands of manipulators and controlling, I declare them that they will not manifest. They will not stand in the mighty name of Jesus. Every demonic dispatched against your life, receive confession and fight themselves. Let them receive confession and fight themselves in the name of Jesus. Let every demon, the demon that is operating those people, that people, those people are controlling you, and now they use witchcraft. Let those demons dispatched against your life receive confession and fight themselves in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them start fighting themselves. Let them fight themselves until they let you go in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every dark projection and manipulation against you be rendered narrow and avoided in the mighty name of Jesus. Every dark projection and manipulation against you be rendered narrow and avoided in the name of Jesus. I destroy them. I destroyed every projection and manipulation against you. Every dark projection, that dark projection and manipulation against you, I render them narrow and avoided in the mighty name of Jesus. Today they will not want to have any access in your life. They will not manipulate you anymore. It is enough. You have been manipulated. You have been controlling. Now let the fire of God fall upon them and consume them in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, celebration of poverty around your destiny, I command them scatter. That is celebrating poverty. You know, poverty, they celebrate. When you are crying, you are poor, you don't have anything, you are broke, they celebrate. They celebrate, they feel so good. They want you to cry all the time. That's when you make them happy. When you have money in the pocket, they are sad. They will not be happy. But when you are broke, you have nothing, you are crying all the time, they are celebrating. Therefore, I command that celebration of poverty in your destiny, in your life, to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You know, when you are being controlled, manipulation, for example, is your husband who will provide food, provide everything, is controlling you. Now you feel that if I leave, how am I going to rent? How am I going to do this and this? Now I will be poverty. I will be in poor, so I don't know what to do. Then you start crying. You start thinking, how are you going to do? And then the enemy that called poverty celebration, they started dancing. They started dancing. Hey, hey to you. Now when they start dancing, they say, yes, 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 yes. We are happy. We have achieved. We have achieved our goal. So let that poverty celebration die. Let them destroy it in the name of Jesus. That's why many people, they can't go anywhere. Because they are thinking that let me be controlled, let me be staying in this way, because there's nothing I can do. And you continue being manipulated, being controlled until you get sick, you die. Many people, they die physical death, not even spiritual death. A woman was in Africa when I went there last year. This woman and her husband. So the husband, he was against the gospel. He was against the church. The husband doesn't want to see this woman going to church. Even when this woman is praying, if the husband found her praying, he would go and kick that woman from prayer. I know I have my stepbrother. He was so crooked and evil. This is my stepbrother. Now what he did, my brother was reminding me 2 days ago. And his wife, he was a woman leader. Now she was a very devoted woman and she liked to go to church early and she was really devoted. When my stepbrother found his wife in the church and he didn't know that he was a leader of the church, He went there and beat that woman and tear the Bible into pieces. It teared because he was telling her not to go to church, not to worship God. But because he goes to work, this woman used to go and come back and pretend that there's nothing. But one time somebody told him that he goes to church. Now he came and hid. He saw the woman going to church. Now he went up to the church and called the woman from the church and started beating her and tear the Bible into pieces. This my stepbrother, as I was talking to my brother, my blood brother and my stepbrother, I was asking him about him. He told me that the man is mad. Now that he's completely mad, he's running in the street naked because of what he did. Then I was telling my brother that, why can't you call that person? We pray for him and repent because he did so wicked and evil. Now the woman left him. The woman left him and went away. And this woman, my brother was telling me that she's now married with a good person. They go together to church. So my stepbrother, who is now become a mad person, is wandering in the street naked because of what he did. You see, this power is witchcraft. It's not good thing that you need to come across. The woman prayed and refused to be controlled, no more to be controlled. And that is the mistake that my stepbrother did. And now it deleted him to be naked in the streets. I pray that in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that any familiar spirit representing you in the dark world fall down and die in the name of Jesus. I pray that you powers of your father's house using ancestral mistakes to make you suffer, I command them to die in the name of Jesus. You powers, the powers of your father's house using ancestral mistakes to make you suffer, I command them to die in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them be destroyed and be bound in the name of Jesus. Every investigation demon, guiding demons and dedicated demon assigned to your life, I command them to receive God and be separated from you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, I thank you, Father. I pray that God Almighty will deliver you. Every demonic bad luck and chains used against you in the dark world, I command them to catch fire and cut to pieces in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. Every demonic bad luck and chains used against you in the dark world, I command them to catch fire and to be cut to pieces in the name of Jesus. Every demonic, every evil demonic, yes, thank you, Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you, Father. Every evil dominion and the controlling of your life, any power that is controlling your life by evil spirit, I command them to break in Jesus' name. I command them to break by fire in the name of Jesus. Every evil dominion and the controlling of your life, every evil dominion and the control of your life that people are controlling, anyone that is controlling you by evil spirits, I command them to break by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. I release you from every negative subjection to nothing or to a person in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil tie, every evil links, every evil bands projected to manipulate your life, I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Every evil ordinance against your life, I command them to render narrow and avoided in the name of Jesus. I am praying that God will deliver you tonight. You will never be manipulated in the mighty name of Jesus. Every counselor and decision by satanic priests and prophets for your life shall not stand, neither shall they come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. If you need prayers, because I'm praying, I can't see, call me. Call our numbers in the name of Jesus. Call our numbers. Call our numbers. Our number is 647-608 5207. If you need prayers, call our number, call us, call me after the prayer. I don't read there properly, so some people, they can be writing, and I don't see properly. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Yes, God, you are a wonderful God. Loving Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I am praying for you. Those wicked people who are writing, who are saying things, they are the ones that I'm praying against them. The God Almighty is going to visit them. I pray that God will deliver you. Call me. I will pray for you. If you have any needs, call me or just leave the message there. I will see and then I will pray for you. Our number is 905-487-7196. Call me after the prayer. Don't call me right away because I can't take it. I can't take the call. After the prayer, call me. I will pray for you. If you have any needs, go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. Write your prayer request. If you need me to pray for you, just go there and write or send email. overcomersdhm@gmail.com. overcomersdhm@gmail.com. All text me. Our text message, text or WhatsApp me, 647-608-5207. If you need prayers, I am still praying for you. Every counselors and decision by satanic priests and prophets for your life shall not stand, neither shall they come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray you satanic priests and prophets hired against your life, drink your own portion and fail unto your evil desires in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, there are some satanic hired priests and prophets that have been sent to come and manipulate the church, to come and manipulate you, to come and portion you. They come and destroy your life completely. Let them drink their own portion and their blood in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You satanic priests and prophets hired against your family, against you, let them drink their own portion and fail unto their own evil. Let them defer their own evil. Let hand change hand. Let power change hand in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your name become coated with the fire of God. Wherever it is being called for evil, let the thunder fire of God locate it, answer in the name of Jesus. That is a good prayer you can pray for your name. That's what I pray. I pray like this. Let my name be coated with the fire of God. Wherever it's been called for evil, let the thunder answer of God answer them. Let the thunder of God answer them. When they call my name, let the fire of God answer them. Wicked people, they do that. They take your name. They call you from the cauldron. They want to manipulate you. They don't sleep. You are sleeping them. They don't. They want to control. They chant and speak. They curse the congregation. Now they are hired priest and wicked personality that they come and start manipulating people. You think it is easy to manipulate people? They have to some powers. They threaten you and they chant. They call names and names and they call you. They said you will not be able to talk. They torment your heart, your head. So when they call your name, let thunder answer. Let fire answer. When they call you Christine, Isigi, hear me. They will hear tarapalaka. They will hear thunder answering them. Or fire of God coming and start burning them. Live fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. Live fire. Yeah. Wicked people are there. This is the deliverance and the healing ministry. This is spiritual warfare. If you have no idea, that's what happened. These manipulator dictators, they call your name in a cauldron. They call your name in a pot, in witchcraft pot, in witchcraft house. They go there and they call your name there. And they manipulate you, they spell on you and put manipulate, and they put spell on you. That's when they can control you. Because you remember themselves, nobody can control them. Nobody can manipulate them, according to the book of Matthew that Jesus was talking. But them, they want you to, they want them to control you. No way. I have refused, even me. I have refused right anyone who will come to my life to control me, to manipulate me. Let this person fall down and die. Because the Bible says they will be cast. This spirit that is controlling anybody, controlling you, they should be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any area of your life being controlled by any demonic, receive the blood of Jesus and be set fire in the name of Jesus. Let them set fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Any area of your life being controlled by any demonic, receive any demon, receive blood of Jesus and be set free in Jesus' name. Evil, every evil charm and potion in your blood, I cast you out by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your blood be transferred with the blood of Jesus to inject any evil deposited in your life in Jesus' name. Every demonic point of contact to the ladder of your destiny, catch fire. I command every demonic point of contact to the ladder of your destiny. You know, point of contact where the demon will climb and enter you. Let that ladder be cut into pieces. I destroy point of contact. If they are using your pictures, they are using anything, your money, that point of contact to manipulate you, I set them fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Any object representing your glory at any witchcraft coven, I command them to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Your glory, your hair, your glory, when they are being manipulated, they are being taken to the witchcraft coven, I command them to catch fire in Jesus' name. Demonic utterance, invocation, spells, including charms and ailment, buried hunger, or hidden in your house, be melted by fire of God in the name of Jesus. I disconnect your glory from the evil flowing of your father's house and your mother's house in Jesus' name. Anything planted in your life, giving information, informant, demons, report about your life, die in the name of Jesus. Anything planted in your life, giving information, demons, reports about your life, let them die. You know there is something which would be planted when you are being manipulated by dark manipulation. You find yourself telling the enemy all information. You start talking, telling them you can't hide anything. You tell your enemy all information. When you tell them, they go and report you and they finish you. That is what we call dark manipulation. Let this power be destroyed. Anything planted in your life, planted by this witchcraft, to make you to say everything. You know, this is manipulation witchcraft, honestly speaking. There are this some wicked priests or pastors. They when they cast out demon, yes, I know the demon can talk and the demon can talk. There was a case. This woman of God, she is a woman of God being born again, delivered. She's not a witch. And now she went to the church, to the meeting. And then this is a meeting where people, they start talking about themselves. The woman found herself calling herself a witch, talking things that she's not. So the demon entered in her spirit because she went to a wrong church where there's a lot of demon manifesting. Then the demon manifested to her. Then she started talking like them, that I'm a witch, I do this and this. And she's not. By the time she was rescued and she went for deliverance, she was so much disgraced. Because where you go to the churches, where you hear those demons talking, you don't know what those pastors are doing. You don't know. You just go because you have had witchcraft being manipulated and manifested, and then you go there and you have no idea what those people are doing. You must know the pastor, if he's a man of God or he's not a man of God, because the demon, they do that. Therefore, I pray that let those dark manipulation programmed in your life be destroyed in Jesus' name. I know spiritual warfare very well. And demons, they can do anything to manipulate people and destroy the life of people. And you know the demons, they are looking innocent people. If you don't know them, they will come for you and destroy you very well. because people are looking for help. They don't know where they go. They just wander. They go anywhere, and you enter in their hands, they would torment you properly. Some people, they enter in some churches, which is a very demonic church. You know, Jesus said, many will call me Lord, Lord. Even some will say, Jesus, I'm here. But don't believe them. Don't let them manipulate you. That's what Jesus said. Don't believe them. Every evil birds calling your cases to dark meetings, cross around in the name of Jesus. Every evil bird calling your case to dark meetings, cross around in the name of Jesus. You know the birds, they come at your window or your gate or wherever you are, they started making noise. And the reason they are innocent. Some birds are not innocent. They are satanic birds. They are birds from witchcraft. The witchcraft have sent them. I'm not saying that all birds are bad. No, they are satanic birds that the Bible talks about. They are sent by witchcraft. And they can come and listen and take it to the witchcraft and give them the information. When you see them, don't take things for granted. Any bird, if they are a wild, they have no idea they are innocent, that's fine. If they are a witchcraft, send fire. You birds standing in my door, what are you doing there? I command you to catch fire. Die in the name of Jesus. Don't let them stay there and you have no idea if they have been sent by witches, by enemy. Yeah? Like FBF or America or even here, Canada, we don't take things for granted. If we see some strange things, we must investigate. We must check what kind of this person. Neighbors, watch neighbors. We watch each other. We don't take things for granted. That's how you should be. Like the chicken, when the chicken is eating, they don't eat and look down only. They are always sharp, looking up and looking for the enemies. That's how you have to be sensitive. Even if you see the flies flying, or some of them, they are innocent. Some of them, they are demon. They have been sent by the devil. So you don't take things for granted. As a spiritual warfare minister, when you see this, scatter them. If they are innocent, fine. If they are a demon, that is, let them go in Jesus' name. That's how it is. Many people, they infect them, they pee on them, they shit on them, and they take your anointing, and then they left. But don't take things for granted. If the flies, they are innocent, that's fine. But if they are demonic, you have done yourself good. It's not that everything is devil, no. We are in the wicked world. People are so wicked. Witchcraft, they are ruling all over. They are taking over everywhere. So you don't take things for granted. Yesterday we were sitting here and we saw hand running to my computer, just like somebody's doing very quickly. They entered to my computer and I saw it. I just broke my computer immediately. We were talking here. Then I saw somebody grabbing like a human being, just come and enter and started taking the information very quickly. And this, my computer has a firework. I don't know what we call it. Firework. I don't know what they call it. It has got the antivirus, but the enemy, it doesn't care. When they want to destroy, they will come. I pray that God will destroy them in Jesus' name. Every dark power projecting evil unto your dwelling places, scatter in the name of Jesus. I withdraw every identity of you from the book of oppression and failure in the name of Jesus. Every problem in your life rooted in demonic world be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray that every problem, I pray that God would deliver you from every problem in your life rooted in the demonic world be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every problem, any problem rooted from demonic world, let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus. And pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus. All evil eyes monitoring your ways and your life receive blindness. This is the work of the enemies. They monitor your ways. They monitor you. That's why I tell you, manipulators, they always investigate you. They check everything in you. They monitor you. Then they know how to manipulate you. Let their eyes be go blind in Jesus' name. Let their eyes be go blind completely in the name of Jesus Christ. let the enemies of your soul be confounded and be put to a shame in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, engulf every arrows of oppression in your life in Jesus' name. I pray that in the mighty name of Jesus, I withdraw all your documents, your properties, materials belongs to you from evil altars in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything that has been taken to the evil altars, that is crying from satanic altars, let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let God arise and let all his enemies be scattered and truth, and let all the enemy be scattered in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, let God arise and let all his enemy be scattered. Let God arise and let all his enemies scattered. Let God arise and let your enemy be scattered in the name of Jesus. We are dealing with the great enemy called dark of manipulation and controlling in the mighty name of Jesus. Anywhere where you are being controlled, those wherever is controlling you, they will be disgraced and exposed in the name of Jesus. They are going to be disgraced and exposed in Jesus' name. This week is a week of disgrace and expose those wicked personality, false prophets, false teachers, false apostles. This is their week. This month, they are going to be exposed and disgraced. Many of them, they will even commit suicide in the mighty name of Jesus. I break every covenant with the false and fake prophets in the mighty name of Jesus. I break their covenants. I break the covenant of false and fake prophets in the mighty name of Jesus. I break covenant with the occult spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. I reject the spirit of heaviness and dizziness in the name of Jesus. Spirit of heaviness and dizziness, I break you, I destroy you, I bind you, and I command you to get out in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bind the spirit of conviction and fear in the name of Jesus. The spirit of conviction and fear this manipulator has put into your life, let this spirit be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind them, I reject them, I render them powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I want to praise your name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I want to thank God for you. Thank you. Thank you so much. I have to stop here. God bless you so much. I pray that God will help you in the mighty name of Jesus. Share this video. And I don't know if I'm going to post it in a YouTube or on a website. I'm not sure, but if I put it, you receive in the name of Jesus. So call me. If you need prayers, our number is 647-608-5207. You can reach us through email. You can email me. You can email us, overcomers@gmail.com. WhatsApp is the best that you can. Everybody's now having WhatsApp. You can always reach me through WhatsApp. And if you need prayers, as I've said early, call us. Our number is 905-487-7196. I will pray for you. If you feel you are being manipulated and being controlling, call me. I'll destroy that spirit. You need to be set free. The Bible said, do not let anyone deceive you. Do not let anyone to astray you. Do not, Paul says, condemn them. This is what Paul says. If there is anybody preaching apart from the gospel that you are preaching, even if it's the angel from heaven, let them be cast. They should be cast. That's what Paul says. Paul has said so. Let them be cast. Let that person be cast in the name of Jesus. We pray that God will cast out and destroy manipulators and controlling in your life. That spirit must be cast out, must get out of your life in the name of Jesus. The tormenting that the demon they have put on you, let them be wiped out from your head in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow, midnight. We are on tomorrow midnight, 12 midnight. 12 midnight, we are on. Invite your fellows, invite friends. We are dealing with spiritual warfare prayer. So this prayer, the witchcraft, they don't like. Pastors, they don't, some pastors, some people, they don't like these prayers. And this is the prayer that will deliver you, will get you out of the box. You have been locked in the box for many years. it is your time to jump out and come, I will help you. If you don't have a spiritual mother, you don't have a spiritual father, you don't have a church, call me. I am here to help you, to give you a cover. I am here to cover you. I am here to support you and stand with you in the mighty name of Jesus. I am here to take you and take care of you with my two hands. Don't suffer. Today we thank God for Periscope. We thank God for the media. You are not alone. You are not alone. Don't be manipulated by pastors because you have no church, you have no place to go. I am here for you. Just call me and let me know. Anywhere in the world, I am here for you and I will take care of you. Sometimes even you don't know these pastors, but you use the spirit of manipulate and controlling you, then you feel yourself you are a slave. Don't let that pipers refuse you. Don't let them. Because themselves, you can't do to them like that. Nobody will do that to them like that. Them, they want to do you everything they want. That's a lie from the bottomness of the pit in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank God for you. Thank you very much. God bless you. See you tomorrow. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. Bye. See you tomorrow midnight. Bye-bye. Bye.